está.
Lesser vampires would heed a higher vampire's call and commands.
As a rule, they don't.
So how Detloff sick them on the city?
I told you, he's exceptional. He manages to bend them to his will, control them with his thoughts. They'll continue attacking until he orders them to back down, or until he dies.
Itself didn't kill him. Bled to death afterwards.
If we'd only arrived a bit earlier.
They broke formation. Ran.
That scent. It's Damien's blood. He was wounded.
Let's go. Street.
Pointless. That's an obstacle to a vampire.
They didn't know. I didn't get a chance to prepare for it. Must be in the bank. Barricaded themselves inside.
I cannot let you recognize the vampire. He's going, you must be safe.
Killed it. Single-handedly. That harlot's brood slaughtered half my unit.
I see the harlot's brood.
Need to it. Mind you
won't. Keep. Got a different plan. Harlot.
You.
Folk are dying. Many more will.
If I. Wait. Wait.
Let's go, Regis.
Playrooms beyond this door.
Locked. Of course. Regis, rather not have a fist fight with this door. Do you mind?
Not at all. Service.
A tin knight. Well, well, a key tucked behind a picture.
A rocking horse, rather worn.
Many miniature tableware. Some plush toys. Cute. What a nice tune. What a duck.
Somebody broke its wings off.
Somebody broke its wings off. What the?
I'm not.
It's chill.
I curse. The on it by the is.
Wait.
Read. Mate, I cannot. We're happy. Did. I see it when she.
In the. Not him.
Where's that book? Locked. Miniature tableware and plush toys. Cute. Nothing under the carpet.
Did you expect something? Apart from the dust swept under there by a lazy chambermaid.
Nothing under the carpet.
Did you expect something? Apart from the dust swept under there by a lazy chambermaid.
Is it? Let's see. Regis? Regis! I am the hell, everything's going wild. All land's an illusion. It's so powerful, there's no way to dispel it.
Let him out!
Voices.
He gobbled up my gingerbread! Now it's my turn to gobble him! Hands off my hearth, dearie! You wouldn't want me to get cross. Then you open it. Now, who's this? A lost traveler? You're not supposed to be here, sweetie. Why, you're old. Old and pale. But never worry. A bit of butter, a bit of spice, and you'll make a tasty morsel. As soon as I catch you.
Ah!
rotting carcass. Careful she doesn't douse you.
It's Prince Charming's. He no longer needs it. Here it is.
Thank you. She'd have begged me for certain if you'd not... Sienna? Is that you?
It's been years, Jack.
Have you come to play?
No, I just want your beans. So you can breathe easy.
Breathe easy? Because you aren't here to play? What's that about?
Jack knows what I mean. So he'll tell me where the beans are as fast as he can. Isn't that right?
Sienna, I'm sorry, but I haven't got them.
Oh. So...
I'm telling the truth. I swear it. Honorietta. She ordered them buried all over so you wouldn't be able to leave.
Where?
I don't know. But Joss, the boy with the thing for wolves, he should know. He sticks his nose in everyone's affairs.
He had better know. Because if not, I'll find you and we'll have ourselves a little talk. Understand? Now shoo. All right. So why is it you're here?
Came to free you.
Nice of you, but a waste of your effort. I plan to free myself.
You might not. Bound to be easier with my help, as our most recent adventure amply showed.
Mm-hmm. Yet I still don't know why you even give a damn.
It's Dedlof. He's trying to force Anna Henrietta's hand. Wants her to release you. Summoned monsters to attack Beauclair.
Sounds like Dedlof, all right. But I doubt you came all this way just to bring me up to speed on current events. So get to the point, please.
Isn't it obvious? Offering to be your ally. We both want you out of here. You because you want your freedom back. Me because as soon as you meet with Dedlof, he'll put an end to the chaos in the city.
You exposed me. I landed in prison because of you. Now you come to beg my help, I dare say. My life is full of surprises, isn't it? But normally I'd tell you to sod off. But, from what you say, folk are dying who have nothing to do with this. Not part of the plan. Dedlof was only to kill those who deserved it. No one else. Fine, Witcher. I accept your offer. Consider us allies. Shake on it.
So?
There are two ways out of this land. My darling sister blocked one when she tossed me in here. The other's up there, in the clouds. She made it hard, but not impossible to access by concealing the beams.
Still don't understand.
Don't fret, just listen. That boy, that was Jack, of Beanstalk fame. You know the tale?
Jack climbed a gigantic beanstalk to a giant's castle, high up in the clouds.
As we shall do if we can just find those blasted beans. There are three. One red, one blue, one yellow.
Stalk won't sprout from just one?
No, because it must transpire exactly as it did in the tale. Clear now? So we must find Joss. Perhaps he will be able to help us. You lead. Joss can usually be found wandering the glade at the foot of the mount. It's some distance from here, past the witch's house to the right. So, what exactly is happening in the city?
Bloodshed. A massacre. Which is why we gotta hurry.
You needn't fret. Time flows differently in the Fabled Sphere. We can stay here a week, but outside, mere minutes will have passed. Watch out! Pixies! To protect the Fabled Sphere from intruders. Meaning you. Oh, unicorns! We must catch them. We won't have to walk everywhere then. I call the pink one. Exciting, isn't it? Reminds me of my childhood.
Reminds me of something altogether different.
Care to elaborate?
Thank you.
not.
That's him. Joss! Last of the rhythm effects! Behind you! Ignore him. He always lies.
Aha. Boy who cried wolf. Still does, I suppose. And doesn't, when they actually appear.
The one and only. Listen, you little chit. Jack said you know what's become of his three beans.
I don't know anything! Not one thing! And besides, watch out! Wolves!
This'll be interesting. Right. Let's get to it. Let's say for a minute you know what happened to the red bean. Where wouldn't it be?
For certain no one swallowed it. Oh no, definitely not that.
Of course not. But say someone didn't. Who would it be that didn't swallow it?
A human. The most human human in the land of a thousand fables. Everyone! Wolves! Run!
Bet you haven't heard what happened to the blue bean. Maybe? Not at all? Right?
I've heard it lies about somewhere, out in the open.
Just like that? No one guarding it?
Nobody! Three times over! Help! Wolves!
Yellow bean. Don't know a thing about it, right?
It's somewhere very, and I mean very deep. So deep, in fact, it's completely underground.
And who has it,
A bold farmhand, who in no way and not at all awaits someone. Not in the slightest. Good folk! Wolf!
Say that word one more time and I'll chop you up. Feed you to the fishes. Understood?
All right, we should go.
Watch out for wolves!
Tough to talk to, that one.
Was it, though? You need merely remember he always lies. Or more precisely, refers us the truth.
Where to now?
I'm not sure. We should visit some of the other fables. The meaty ones, that is. Perhaps then Joss's hints will make more sense. It's just a few. Red Riding Hood, piglets and bears, three of each. And Goldilocks, of course. Then Longlocks, and a little lass who sells flint.
Fine. Let's get to work. Incredible. You must have loved this place.
I did at first. But children get bored quickly. Even tea parties with a whole cackle of princesses eventually turn dull and routine.
What did you do then?
Dropped a duck egg in the swan's nest once. That sort of thing. Stole the pea out from under the princess. Who sleeps to this day, I think. Stop prodding me and find the beans, Witcher. Hello, girl, Witcher.
Three bears.
Three stools, three beds, three bowls.
One a bit too big, the other too small, the third just right.
Someone. I shall butcher you!
stop prodding me and find the bees.
Blonde curls. Rest of the body's too mutilated. Hard to say anything.
She got what she deserved, as I see it. Always took what she wanted without asking.
No bean here. Gotta keep looking.
Oh, look! The Emperor of Nilfgaard! He's come out to show off his new robe.
Hello? Can we talk?
Schmumbotch, my head! Damn it all! I swear that was the last time I drank with Redbeard. Oh, Sianna. A bloody long time it's been. You've changed.
Whereas you, not at all, big bad wolf. Though it seems you've started running with the wrong crowd.
And who should I run with, eh? Thumbelina? One shot and she's under the table. But that, what brings you?
Listen, looking for magic beans. Seen any?
I was given one for safekeeping, but...
Where is it? Talk!
Shh, not so loud.
Oh, I can be much louder than this. And resort to other means of persuasion.
Oh, right there, the threats. Sianna to a T. Listen, I exist to restage a fairy tale. If you want to play at it, I'll be happy to oblige. But it won't be easy. The thing is, little Red Riding Hood's popped her clogs.
What?
1,000 times they cut my gut open, filled it full of rocks and drowned me in the river. So once you stopped coming, I decided to repay the little imp for all her loving labor. Who'd now what's at the bottom of the well, she and the hunter, which means we can't play, and I'm under no obligation to talk to you, not about beans, nor anything else. So leave me be. Sod off.
So, what now?
Don't worry. I'll play with him. No, rather, play him. I just need that little red hood. The piece of apparel, that is. Not the poor girl's corpse.
That's a relief.
You wish to help me? Here's your chance. Jump in the well and fish it out. Well, chop chop.
Jump in the well.
Break a leg. Any luck?
Yep. Look what I got.
That would never fit you. Give it to me. How do I look?
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Let's go see the big bad wolf.
Let me guess. You'll play the granddaughter.
Mm-hmm. And you, the hunter.
You again? I thought I was clear. I will not talk to you if little Red Riding Hood is not with you.
Not a problem. Sianna can take her place.
What? Very well. It's not as if I can forbid you.
Grand Hotel, come closer, sweetie.
But Grandmama, what big eyes you have.
They're better to see you with, my dear.
Granny, what big arms you have.
The better to embrace you with, my dear.
And Grandmama, what big teeth you have. Eh?
The better to eat you with, my dear.
Joss said.
Mm-hmm. Bottle caps.
Well then.
What?
Now I find myself wondering if you're just horribly discreet, or if those mutations completely scrubbed away your curiosity. In your shoes, I'd have myriad questions. For instance, Sianna, whatever became of you after they drove you out? But you, nothing. You avoid all talk of it.
Since
the they assumed something would eat me, or that I'd do everyone a favor and die of hunger. But as always, I failed to live up to expectations. I wandered the woods for a week, went purple from the cold, gnawed the bark from twigs. Finally, I saw a light among the trees. A campsite. They were bandits, bearded, drunk, spattered with blood. I was sure they'd rape me or kill me. Or both.
Take it neither happened?
That's when I learned a robber and a murderer can be a better man than a knight in shining armor. They took me in, we set off for Nizer, and I did what I could to repay them. I advanced in their ranks rather quickly. Eventually, I became their leader. Of the whole ragged band.
Been through a lot.
I have. And throughout this time, my sister was stomping grapes and shagging minstrels on down bedding.
She wasn't the one to banish you.
And I'm not angry at her for that. I'm angry at her because she forgot about me. Right. We've had our chat. Come.
Like Anna Henrietta?
You jest, I adored her. My darling little sis. So adorable. So sweet. Yet when they banished me from the palace, she didn't so much as peek out of the window.
She might not have known. Maybe just couldn't.
And could she also not grant me amnesty when she was crowned? Please. Oh, the Three Little Pig Songs. You know the story, don't you? Who's afraid of the big bad wolf?
Looks like Big Bad's already blown down the houses of straw and sticks. Brick's the only one left. One beam lies out in the open, guarded by...
The coverage they didn't like that!
The big bad Witcher huffed and puffed, and look, got a beam.
It cannot be.
What cannot be?
You actually have a sense of humor.
Why so shocked?
Well, when you arrived, all you did was pout and mumble things in that gruffly monotone. And now this, a jest. And a good one at that. But here we are chatting away when there's work to do. We must keep looking. So, do you like it here?
No. Got a problem with magic in general. Illusions, portals, all that. Don't trust any of it.
A bow of old-fashioned tastes, eh?
This long-lost tower?
Indeed. It's even taller than I remember.
Wait. What Joss said about the third beam, remember?
In the possession of a bold farmhouse somewhere deep beneath the ground. Yes, this must be it. Let's go.
Could pull myself up here, and I'll have to make that jump.
If you say so, I shall wait down here if it's all the same. Climbing snow by strong suit.
His corpse. Tried to free Longlocks, but fell and broke his neck. stumped to climb all that way for nothing.
So?
Got the bean, but long locks. Seems she got sick of waiting for a knight in shining armor.
Can you blame her? Men these days, dandies and fops all.
That why you cozied up to a vampire?
Detlaf was a tool, and only a tool.
Too bad he didn't know that.
I trust no one. Learned that long ago. Now it's his turn.
Got a history with Detlaf now, so this meeting will be different. Not afraid.
I can handle him.
Sure about that?
You look at him as a witcher and see a monster. I know what he's really like. You needn't worry. It's time to go. Just a bit more work and we'll be able to say sot off to this feckin' fable sphere. Now we must plant them by the path near Longlock's tower. Then prepare to meet the giant. Wait!
Why?
This stalk will sprout abruptly, very abruptly. We must be careful. All right, toss them!
Something's always gotta go wrong.
The home stretch. Admire the view later. First, we must deal with... him.
I'll be free at last.
Fairy tale creature, that was one tough son of a wench.
I told you this land had gone ape mad, though I did not expect it to be so severe.
Can't help thinking you might have done that on purpose.
Why ever would I have?
To get rid of your guard, your captor. Getting close to the exit at this point, probably think you don't need me anymore.
Well, you're wrong. You still stand to be quite useful to me.
That so? How? Plan to use me like you did Detloff?
No, I need you for a purpose far simpler. Well, don't just stand there and stare. I need a man, Geralt, and I'm not afraid to say it. I have no idea what awaits me once we leave this place. Treat it as my last wish.
Thank you.
Just gonna go our separate ways. No parting words.
Did you wish to tell me something?
Actually, it'd probably be best.
Oh my. No woman's ever treated you this way.
Not that I recall, no.
In that case, at last you felt what so many women in this world feel at times.
I just hope this tale has a happy ending. For me, for you, for everyone.
That may very well depend on you.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing beyond what you heard. For now. Come. The exit's this way.